Okay, so we have a few tips, I guess, for you and what Jay thinks and what I think about sort of what to do and what to do when you are meeting your mother-in-law or your boyfriend's mom or whatever for the first time. And number one would be 선물 가지고 가야지. 선물은. 사람 한국에 사람 집에 처음 갈 때 좀 선물 작은 거 좀 가지고 와야지. 뭐 너무 비싼 거 말고
부모님들
뭐 어머니 그런 거 가지고 가야지.
아니 어머니 화장품 같은 거 괜찮을 것 같아.
화장품 괜찮지만 청혼만 할 때 어떻게
왜?
딱 어떤 거 사야 돼?
뭐 어머니들은 그냥 비싼 거 다 좋아해.
뭐 그리고 과일도 괜찮지.
과일은 과일 괜찮겠다.
과일, you know, bring some fruit or like some not makeup, but like face creams and stuff like that for the mom, or like bring something that you can like give to them. I mean, I wouldn't go crazy expensive, so it looks like you're bribing them, but just something that's like really good manners, like, you know, it's nice to meet you and I brought this, just like you would do in the States if you're going to someone's house for the first time, or even if you're meeting them outside.
엄청 많이 먹어야지. 한국 밥
먹어야지.
아, 그거 좀 중요해.
엄청 많이 먹어야지. You have to eat a lot. Like don't do that. 뭐, 어머니 그냥 너한테 밥 이거 먹어보고 그냥 저거 이렇게.
팁이 있어. 그냥. 어머니 이거 진짜 맛있는데요. 이거 뭐예요?
네. Yeah. Oh, this is so good. What is this? You have to like really like don't just eat it like, you know, you're being polite like. You know, like that kind of thing, like, if you do that, then, like, I feel like the 어머니, 좀 맛있, yeah, 좀, wow, oh, 이거 맛있다, 이거 맛있다,
right?
Exactly. You have to really eat, like, a lot, and eat it really well, and, you know, it's okay in Korea to smack, you know, 시끄럽게도 먹을 수 있는, 그냥 진짜 잘 먹어야지. I think it's a good thing because it shows the mom that you are respectful of the culture and that you are making an effort to sort of learn more about Korea and that you like Korean stuff, and that's what they're really worried about, that you don't like, you know, that you're not gonna eat Korean food, you're just gonna eat bread every day. They kind of think those sort of things, so you gotta try your best. Okay, number three.
한국어 조금 배워야지. 아니면 그 아줌마 언어 그
어머니
sorry 나
어머니요 커뮤니케이션.
Yeah. 저 그 언어 조금 배워야지. 뭐 많이. It's okay. 뭐 if you don't know a lot, like then just learn a few things like 어 맛있어요 or like 어 잘 먹었어요. 뭐 그런 거 좀 배워야지. 안녕하세요. 진짜 조금만 얘기할 수 있으면 어머니 얼마나 행복해.
조금 처음에 신기하게 생각할 거야. 그러면서 어 얘는 한국말 하구나 이렇게 생각을 하면 그 모르겠어. 그 어머니가 진짜 싫지 않은 이상은 거기서 조금 더 인센티브가 들어가지 않나.
Kind of yeah, so I think like just learn like a few, if you don't know the language at all, then learn a few things. And I think it's really important. If you're dating someone whose family doesn't speak your language, it's really, really important that you learn. And it's just a sign of respect. And it shows that you respect that person, you respect their culture enough to learn the language. And their parents are going to be so much more impressed. And they think like, 너가 엄마 많았을 때 나 한국어 좀 할 수 있으니까 우리 사이 조금 더 빨리 편하게. Yeah, I think it helped. So learn the language. This is important. This isn't like a side thing. This is a main thing. Okay. Okay. So the next thing would be 그 사람 나를 이메일로 배워야지.
맞아. 특히
갈 때죠.
특히 올 사람 만날 때.
You have to know like Korean manners and Western manners are quite different. So I mean, there are things that I would never do when I met, you know, an American. You know, like one of my friend's moms or something that I definitely have to do when I meet a Korean mom. So, 그 매너 진짜 잘 배우고 그냥 갈 때 전에 남자친구 남자친구한테 물어봐야지. 아, 너 어머니 만날 때 어떻게 해야지?
뭐 좋아해?
뭐 좋아해? 어떻게 앉아야지?
뭐 싫어해?
멋이야. 그 지금 매너 온 매. 잠깐만. 오케이. 그런 거 진짜 물어봐야지.
맞아.
갈 때 좀. Yeah, you never know like what stuff is just like not acceptable in the culture, and so I think if you're meeting, you know, not just a Korean mom, but any mom from, you know, if your partner's from another country, like you should just learn what good manners are, so that you can go there prepared to sort of blow them away with your manners.
그리고 마지막은 내 생각은 이거는 진짜 큰일이야.
In my English, I would say like don't date like a punk ass mom's boy. Like you can't date 그
그냥 남자 많으면 진짜 어머니 얘기하는 거 다 하는 뭐 mama's boy 같은 남자 많으면 그냥 안 돼.
그렇게 그런 남자 만나면 특히 내 생각으로는 외국인하고 결혼 못 해.
못하지. 그래서 don't do it. Just don't. Like don't date a mama's boy. 엄마 mama's boy 만나지 말고.
오히려 그냥 좀 혼자 집에 밖에서 좀 살고 좀 혼자 행동 좀 많이 하는 사람, 프리스타일 그런 남자들하고 막 하고 만나야 특히 외국인들
짜증 많을 수 있지.
국제 결혼 같은 거는 잘 할 수 있다고 나는 생각을 하고. 어머니 말씀 잘 듣고 물론 잘 들어야 되지만 어머니 말씀 잘 듣고 아버님 말씀 잘 듣고 아버지 이거 해 어머니 저거 해 이렇게 하나만 하는 사람은 외국인하고 내 생각은 절대 결혼 못하지.
그래 한국에 그런 남자 엄청 많다.
많겠지.
진짜 there's a lot of guys like that in Korea. So I think you should be careful because a lot of them will date you in private. But as soon as it comes to introducing you to their parents, it's just over because, you know. So yeah, don't date a punk ass mom's boy.
꼭 TV라기보다는 만약에 우리 같은 커플이 있다면 오빠가 제일 중요한 거는 부모님 뭐 마음? 부모님 설득? 이게 중요하지 않아. 남자의 진짜 마음이 중요한 거야. 그 마음이 왜 중요하냐면 그 남자가 결혼하고 싶어. 한 여자랑 외국인이랑 그러면 그걸 끝까지 갖고 가면 돼. 무슨 말인지 알아들어?
Yeah.
부모님이 반대를 하고 주위에서 반대를 할지언정 자기가 진짜 좋아하고 사랑하고 결혼하고 싶으면 왜 결혼을 못해?
That's true.
결혼 못하는 이유는 그 남자가 너랑 진짜 끝까지 책임지고 너하고 결혼하고 싶은 생각이 많이 없는 거야.
I guess that's true. If he wants to marry you, he will marry you. And if he wants to be with you, he will be with you. There's nothing to do. Dating has nothing to do with the parents. And, you know, I agree. But, you know, I think it is, you know, everyone wants to impress their mother-in-law or their future mother-in-law or, you know, their boyfriend's mom or whatever. So, I think it's a good tip to try the things that we suggested. Okay, well, that's it for now. Please subscribe down below and we'll have lots of content for you in the future. And if anybody has any questions, make sure to leave it in the comment section. And we always read those and I generally reply to almost anyone who asks anything. So, yeah, definitely leave a comment and subscribe. And yeah, I guess, 끝이지?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
I'm finished.
You're finished? Okay. All right, so bye everyone.
Bye.